It may not look all that exciting right now, but this is it. This is where it all started.
August 1859, an ambitious lawyer from Illinois came to Council Bluffs on a Missouri River steamboat. Abraham Lincoln had just lost the Illinois Senate race to Stephen Douglas and was testing the western political waters as well as checking out 160 acres of land. Lincoln encountered young railroad surveyor Granville Dodge on the veranda of the Pacific House Hotel. They talked railroads, and Dodge enthusiastically proclaimed the route west from Council Bluffs along the Platte River as the best choice for a transcontinental route.
After Lincoln became president, he issued a vague proclamation that, in effect, designated Council Bluffs as the eastern terminus of the Transcontinental Railroad. That move affected Council Bluffs in Omaha, and maybe all of Iowa and Nebraska, more than anything in history. To commemorate the 50th anniversary of that historic visit, Roar Park in Council Bluffs was renamed Lincoln Park in 1909. Very shortly after the park's dedication, a proposition to erect a monument to honor President Abraham Lincoln was made public. The proposition originated with the Council Bluffs chapter of the Daughters of the American Revolution, the DAR. The spot chosen was Lookout Point, right at the entrance to Lincoln Park. Prominent local architect J. Chris Jensen designed the monument, and the Lincoln Monument was officially dedicated October 10, 1911. A son of President Ulysses S. Grant was present for the dedication, and he talked about two meetings between his father and Abraham Lincoln, both of which he personally witnessed. General Dodge talked about his friendship with Lincoln. Years later, the monument was redesigned by landscape architect Fred Schlott. The original electric lights were replaced with two gas torches. Those original torches were lit manually every evening and then extinguished the following morning by two boys who lived on Oakland Avenue. This continued until the 1970s, at which time the torches remained but were left dark. The monument was renovated by the Bluffs Arts Council in 1996. The cracked concrete was replaced with bricks, and the torches turned on again, with Mayor Hanifin ceremoniously lighting a torch. Back in 1938, it was discovered that the date of Abraham Lincoln's visit in Council Bluffs that was on the plaque was actually wrong. When the monument was refurbished in 1996, it was decided not to correct the date because it'd been wrong so long at that point, 85 years, the error was now actually part of the monument's history. The construction work for the refurbishment in 1996 was done by Ray Jensen. Mr. Jensen deliberately submitted a lower than normal bid because he wanted to make sure he got the job so he could keep it in the family. It was his father, Niels Jensen, who constructed the original monument. One more comment regarding that location for the monument. Back in August 1859, while waiting for a meal to be set up in Bayless Park, Congressman H.M. Pusey and Abraham Lincoln strolled to the top of what's now Oakland Avenue and gazed out from that very bluff. Lincoln was silent for a moment as he took in the view. Then he stretched out his long arm and swept it across the western horizon, proclaiming, "Pusey, that valley was made for railroads." It's a great story, but now that might not have actually happened.
Was pretty well covered by both the Nonpareil, which was a pro-Abraham Lincoln newspaper, and also by Lysander Babbitt's Weekly Bugle, which was very anti-Lincoln. And they both detail pretty much everything Lincoln did those 3 days. And there was no mention of any hike. There was no mention of any picnic at Bayless Park. Those stories come out years later. It's kind of all a part of the mythologizing that happened after he was assassinated.
Though Abraham Lincoln may not actually have set foot on that bluff, it is certainly a fact that he was in Council Bluffs. He did talk railroads with Granville Dodge. And later, he did issue that proclamation that determined Council Bluffs to be the point where the East ended.
History is never truly lost until it's forgotten. And preserving that history is our mission. The Historical Society of Pottawatomie County in Council Bluffs, Iowa.